I shipped with a merc who had a gun like yours, Nyoka. He polished it, banged to it, left with it. Not like that, as far as I know.
Sounds like he had himself a discerning palate. Where are you going with this?
He couldn't hit the broadside of an assault cruiser, hence the tin shredder.
Wouldn't be the first man I met bearing compensation for his lack of skill.
Welcome to Terra One, the most Earth-like world in Halcyon. Take a moment to admire the triumph of civilization over nature. And while you're at it, say hello to the local settlers. We hope you've enjoyed this guided tour across the wonders of Halcyon. Please return to the Bureau of Exploration for a special prize.
mess with us.
Well, gotta admit, you're tougher than I expected.
If I never smell another raft, it'll be too soon.
Weren't you a sawbones? Figured you ought to have smelled worse.
Sure, but those things reek like bad cologne. It's different.
I'm with you there. At least humans have the courtesy to wait a while before their bodies start to stink.
Most of them. Who's ready for more?
This mountain can see so much from here. So many beasts would need killing, so many drinks would need drinking.
I've got to do more cardio.
Here we go. I haven't set foot in here since. Well, I'm ready. Yeah. Right? Yeah. Here we go. Hell of a job. What's up?
You gotta teach me that.
Well, this is the spot. You know, I thought I'd be angry. I thought I'd storm in here in a rage and exterminate all these bugs and everything would be all right in the end. But I ain't. I'm mostly just empty. A little sad, maybe. The first night Hayes and I spent in here, we knew it was home. It's safe. It's got a nice chill to it. But mostly, it doesn't stink of sulfur. Monarch folks often joke about it. Not because of the smell or the grittiness it leaves in your throat. Not because of the headaches or the coughing. It's because there's no escaping it. It's life here, and there ain't anything you can do about it. But here, somehow the sulfur never made it. The nights we spent in here felt like vacations. So we started building. We hauled in steel, hired sublight folk to help. That's how we met Anders and Opal. They stuck around after our contract was up. Opal liked camping. Anders liked chasing her tail. Four of us for a while, scraping together what bits we could to build our home. Then came Rebecca, a sawbones out of the Cascadia survivors, who took a kindness to Hayes. And Clara, her little sister. I'll admit I wasn't keen on taking her on at first. But for a teenager, she was surprisingly capable. She had a head for numbers, helped us trade hides for food and materials, negotiated contracts, turned out to be mighty useful. Clara, Hayes, Anders, Rebecca, Opal, and me. Six folks, one name, one family, Charon. Despite Monarch trying to kill us day in and day out, we managed to belong. Me too, Captain. But
I'm starting to think that maybe I've found another. Now let's get to shooting before I get all sentimental.
They're on us!
I wish these were more auspicious circumstances, but at least we're all here. This bringing them together, burying them. This is the kind of thing Hayes would have done. That makes it stupid. By all accounts, we should have left well enough alone, but that also makes it right. Captain, thank you. You mind if we rest a spell before we head out? I'd like to bury Opal and Clara proper before I lay everyone's medallions to rest. What? Why? Them's painful memories, Captain. Huh. That ain't a bad point. All right, Captain. Thanks.
Something on your mind?
You know, I'd been assuming this entire stay on your ship thing isn't a permanent arrangement. Part of my contract? That said, you ain't been eaten or shot to death yet. Says a lot about the stability of your future. And to be honest, I'm about sick of sleeping on bar stools. So how's about this? You keep letting me stay on that ship of yours, and I'll keep shooting at the things you point at. Outstanding.
Crew members Ellie and Max are engaged in a heated discussion in the kitchen.
Max. Maximilian. Vicar. Vicky.
Yes?
Aw, this is no fun anymore.
We are now in orbit above Byzantium, Captain.
I love Byzantium.
What can I do for you, darling? I've been thinking of a name for this new outfit. Chimera. Crafted from the hides of 3 species of monster. While you were gone, I put in an order for one of my bespoke lapels. Solid gold, diamond encrusted. If it doesn't have one of my lapels, it's not a Jolicoeur original. Those slackwits at HPS are holding my parcel while they wait for a signature. Bureaucracy is so utterly insufferable. Be a dear and retrieve it for me. Understatement of the year, darling. Believe me, I'm every bit as frustrated as you are. I know, my dear, you do spoil me, but this outfit is my masterpiece, and that lapel is my signature. I simply must have it. Can you believe the cheek on these people? If I didn't know any better, I'd say they were trying to grift an autograph out of me. Wonderful! I'm giving you authorization to retrieve this parcel on my behalf. You truly are my savior, darling.
Remember that strange voice.
Cosmos Purple Berry Punch.
You want a punch? We've got your punch right here.
How may I be of assistance? If you would like to sign for a parcel, please go to window B.
Welcome to Halcyon Parcel Service, where all parcels are guaranteed to be delivered within acceptable margins of certainty. How may I be of assistance? Let me just look that up for you. It appears that a parcel for Ms. Jolicoeur, Celeste is currently out for delivery. Let me see here. A parcel for Jolicoeur, Celeste is being delivered to 316 Rockwell in the Byzantium Estates. Thank you for allowing HPS to be your only option today.
Vicky. Can I call you Vicky?
Of course. You may address me however you wish.
Vicky, huh? Okay, Vicky it is. You're really gonna let me run with that, aren't you?
Why wouldn't I?
Rumor has it someone's pulling doubles until the retirement district is, repaired.
Halcyon Parcel Service is proud to be the colony's only parcel delivery service. How may I be of assistance? I must respectfully ask that you calm down, please. Parcels must be picked up at window A. Maintaining proper window structure is imperative to the smooth operation of HPS. If you would like to lodge a complaint about the quality of your service, please request a complaint form at window C. If you would like to request a complaint form at window C, please make an appointment. I see you're familiar with our company policy.
How may I be of assistance? Of course. If you could just verify for me that you are Jarlicour, Celeste, or an officially authorized proxy? Yes, I can see by your eccentric mode of dress that you must be one of Ms. Jarlicour's associates. Everything seems to be in order. Here you are, one parcel. I hope this has been a pleasant and satisfying transaction. Halcyon Parcel Service thanks you for your patronage.
I'm afraid I can't come down anymore. Ah!
Spacer's Choice Tartarus Sauce. A tangy sauce made with real atmospheric contaminants from Tartarus. Great on fish sticks.
I've always loved this.
Hey, careful. Don't go running around in the middle of a crime scene. You mean Ms. Jolicoeur? She was reported for practicing a subversive aesthetic. We found her in her office, working on something perverse. She didn't cooperate, so we had to put her down. Never took her for a dissident sympathizer. Byzantium security regrets any disruption to regular flow of commerce. However, cultural and moral hygiene must always be maintained. Byzantium cultural standards are enforced by Universal Defense Logistics. Universal Defense Logistics, your first and last line of defense in the war against sedition.
Sure.
You hear about that dissident working in that clothing store? This is why we've got to be vigilant. Nothing exciting ever happens around here.
Something on your mind?
I love the... Xantium, where... What else are you going to find? Art, culture,
my dear fellow.
It's you. I suppose you're here to collect your prize.
Hmm?
I really do have the worst luck. When I gave you this job, I never expected you'd be so damned competent. Yes, go on and gloat. You've already ruined all my plans with your talent for staying alive. The tour's not real, friend. Board shut it down years ago due to unacceptably high rates of fatalities. So I greased a few palms and got the tour up and running again. I outfitted every beacon with a recording device. Live footage of dim-witted mercenaries dying in gruesome ways across Halcyon. Oh, imagine the ratings. Why the hell shouldn't it be legal? I filed the appropriate paperwork, I paid my dues. Look, never mind. Just take your reward and get out of my hair. One certified explorer's hat, courtesy of the Bureau of Exploration. With my compliments. Hey, welcome back.
I tell you what, we'll change the font in our country.
Ah! Spacer's Choice Dehydrated Water.
That episode from a few weeks ago was...
If I spit, think I can hit that mechanical down there? No, I won't. I'll blame it on you. Something to see an Earth assault cruiser land here.
Don't be ridiculous. There's
Captain, if you're looking for crew members Ellie or Felix, they're sharing a drink upstairs.
You ever notice how our crew's a lot like that crime family from The Masked Marketeer?
Okay, but who's Sam?
Come on, Ellie, Sam ain't people. I guess he can be Chairman Rockwell on that one cameo appearance.
I heard they had an automech read those lines because the actors were afraid of offending the chairman. And what about me?
A scion of Byzantium turned to banditry? You've got to be the Masked Marketeer.